You can measure the speed of an elevator with your smartphone from the inside while you're riding it. This experiment is very simple. All you need is your smartphone and an elevator. The only requirement is that your smartphone has a barometer so it can measure the atmospheric pressure.
Open up FreeFox, which you can get for free from freefox.org, and find the elevator experiment. If the entry is gray, your phone does not have a barometer, and the experiment won't work for you. Open the experiment, place the phone on the floor of the elevator, press the start button, and start the elevator. You should pick an elevator that travels for at least 3 floors. FreeFox measures the change in atmospheric pressure and calculates the height difference from the start of the experiment using the barometric formula. So you can see the height in the graph at the top. The second graph is the derivative of the height difference, giving the vertical velocity. Finally, the bottom graph is raw data from the accelerometer and represents the acceleration of the elevator. As you can see, the elevator accelerates to a constant velocity of about 1.5 meter per second and stops after quite precisely 20 meters with a negative acceleration.
Okay, 1.5 meter per second is not that fast. Maybe we can find something faster. Okay, the elevator in Aachen was a little slow, so we will now try something a little bit faster.
When taping your phone to a quadcopter, you will have trouble to read its display. Therefore, we use the remote access feature of FreeFox and a laptop PC. First, we create a network between both by enabling the hotspot function on the phone and connecting to it on the PC. Then, in the elevator experiment, we need to enable the remote access from the menu and enter the given address into a web browser on the PC. When this is done, we can remotely read out and control the measurement. If you have trouble with this setup, visit freefox.org to find further details. The smartphone is taped to the quadcopter between some foam to dampen vibrations. Then it's time to take off. Unfortunately, the vibrations are still too strong to assess the acceleration, but we can easily track its height and the vertical velocity slightly exceeding 5 meters per second.
Well, 5 meters per second or 18 kilometers per hour is still not that fast. If you're living in a big city with skyscrapers, you will certainly find an elevator which is faster than that. So go there, try it out yourself, and let me know if you find a faster elevator. And until then, see you in the next video.